Hello there, my name is Arindam and in this video I am going to show you how to beat the center boss fight on alpha difficulty solo on full official server settings in 2021. Now before I go any further and show my army, I am going to point out a couple of things. I am playing on single player, and as you know, single player bosses are much weaker than on official server. More specifically, single player bosses have their effective health and damage reduced by 67% or 2/3. This is as of this particular patch. Whatever you see in this particular text document is what I have shown in a previous video. So in a previous video, I had shown you how you can make sure that your single player bosses have the same difficulty level as on official servers by tweaking different things, especially the game.ini. And I had shown you in that video four different boss runs for the four different ways to make sure, to make you understand how difficult the official server bosses are versus any single player bosses. Even the single player settings of bosses are much easier than the full official. Now let's come back. So we have to make sure that this 67% thing is completely deleted. How to do that? So we're going to go to the game.ini and we're going to do this. Dino class damage multiplier for the Megapithecus and the Broodmother has been increased to 3 times. This means that they are going to do 3 times more damage to my Therizinosaurus, which is going to negate the 67% reduction to their damage. Similarly, the class resistance multiplier for the two bosses have also been increased to 3 times, which means that they are 3 times more resistant to my dinos hitting them, which means their effective health is actually 3 times more than their actual health. Well, which means the 67% reduction to their effective health has been removed. So by changing the dino class resistance multiplier and dino class damage multiplier and making them 3x for both of them, your single player bosses are going to have the same difficulty as of official server boss. Other than that, you have the standard things like single player settings which have been turned off, maximum difficulty turned on, difficulty override at 5x and difficulty level slider at 1.0. So now let's come back. In the previous video, I had shown you this exact same boss fight using Shadow Mains. These are the ones, and they kind of made the boss fight look like a joke because these guys are very powerful. But Shadow Main is probably the most powerful boss fighter in the game currently, as far as I think. But I have been used to playing with Therizinosaurus, and this is my new line of Therizinosaurus. And I want to see how good these Therizinos perform so that we can compare how good Therizinosaurus are compared to Shadow Mains. My Therizinosaurus all have Ascendant Saddles between 110 and 124.8. They all have 10 Veggie Cakes, and their health and melee is exactly the same. 22,000 health and around 11-20% melee. And my Eutyranus is have every single level put into health and has an Ascendant Saddle. To start this boss fight, you need to go into any of these boss terminals and you need these tributes, except this one, by the way. You need these 6 artifacts and all of these different tributes. So let's just pop these guys in and start the boss fight. Also make sure that the resource harvesting is disabled for each of them, and you can use this to copy to all of the other Therizinos. And each of them has 10 Veggie Cakes, because on official servers the Megapithecus deals a lot of damage, and the Therizinos 22,000 health is not going to enough to combat the Megapithecus's huge amount of damage. Hence the Veggie Cakes are required. We can already see the Megapithecus from there, but we are going to go into this direction. We're not going to go in that direction because we need to kill the Megapithecus first. For Shadow Mains, I had gone through that direction because the Shadow Mains are stupidly overpowered and I never felt any danger during the boss fight with Shadow Mains. But for Therizinosaurus, I am not sure because the Megapithecus is very powerful. And I want to take this guy out as fast as possible. My Thrasinos are taking a lot of damage. I'll be really lucky to end this boss fight without any casualties, because I'm curious if that's going to happen or not. I'm not really worried about the Good Mother, but the Megapithecus is actually very difficult. A lot of my Thrasinos are in very badly bleeding state, as you can see. Well, one of them is dead. One of my Thrasinos are actually dead. So, just one casualty. But still, T12 is dead. As you can see, this is how difficult these boss fights are. The moment you make sure that your saves are exactly same as official servers. In fact, it's almost too difficult. And mind you, this was only the center boss fight. These were not the, you know, these were not the boss fight on the island map. The island map bosses are much more harder than this. Significantly more harder than this. Me try and take a screenshot before time runs out. Well, I've taken the screenshot and we can see what happened to our Thrasinosaurs. Just look at this. Just look at this. Imagine. So I had 10 veggie cakes and it has already consumed 5 of them, and its health is only 6000, which means that without 10 veggie cakes, these guys would have all died. Just check this guy out also. They have all consumed 5 veggie cakes, as far as I think. And the one that died consumed only 3. And it died because it could not regenerate its health on time. This guy has, well, guy has been completely destroyed. The thing is, I will be able to heal these guys up and I will have to find a replacement for T12. But yeah, well, that's about it. Finally, let's check our Eutyranus. So Eutyranus also lost a bit of health. The most important thing is, I want you to compare and contrast the boss fights between Thrasinosaurs and the boss fight that I did with Shadow Mains. Remember, both the boss fights were on exactly the same settings. And my Thrasinos have veggie cakes, they have ascendant armor and everything else. But the Shadow Mains barely took 5000 to 6000 damage. And these guys do not even have veggie cakes. I have been able... See, I have not even bothered healing these guys up. This was the amount of damage they had taken. I'm actually doing these two boss fights back to back. I did not bother healing these guys up or putting them in cryo. As you can see, these guys did not take any damage, did not have any casualties. But Thrasinosaurs took a lot of pounding from the Megapithecus. The real challenge is going to be how to find out how Thrasinos and Shadowmains compare for a dragon boss fight, especially on the island. because the Therizinos, being herbivores, have a damage reduction against fire, even though Shadowmans have a lot of natural armor as well as pack boost. But that is for a different video. So right now I have completed all of the videos on the center map except one, that is the base tour, which I'm going to be showing you in the next video. If you want to find out all of the artifacts as of 2021 on the center map, I have videos for them. And I also have that really special video in which I have compared how bosses on official servers are different from bosses on single player settings, on, off, and single player on difficult. So in that video I had shown you 4 boss fights with the same set of armies, with the difficulty settings changed to 4 different types. I hope you guys can watch that video and learn how to make sure your single player is like official, but more importantly, to understand how difficult official servers are compared to single player, or even versus any unofficial server. So, you know, till then, I'll see you in the next video, which will be my base tour somewhere here on the north middle jungle island. So, you know, thank you for watching.